nothing better than the boys from back home. I turned 18, ran off and left everything I'd ever known. I'm trying to find a better life, I'm chasing crazy dreams. But no matter where I go, it'll never be the same as the boys from back home. Drinking beer around the muddy brown water, talking about whose mom's hotter in. Paddling down the Nitiscaw River, pushing each other in. Going out to the South Bridge, just a bunch of us country kids. I'm trying to get the freshman girls to flash a little bit of skin. Me and the boys from back home. Bunch of y'all rednecks just like me. I always be proud of where I come from. Know who to call when I'm down to drink something. The boys from back home. Counting down to graduation, it seemed like it'd take forever. Little did we know, be the last time we'd all be together. Hats off to the man overseas, fighting battles for you and me. Lord knows that he'll always be one of the boys from back home. There ain't no place that I'd rather be than with a bunch of y'all rednecks just like me. Always be proud of where I come from. Know who to call when I'm talking about the good old days is always worth our while, yeah, yeah. So if you're with the boys, back home.
You know, we were sitting there taking turns looking.
Raise a glass.
All of a sudden, I was like, oh shit, Kelly, shot. And I thought, just pedaling down, I'm like, he's dead. He's going, and then, oh. And then we hear you, me and Kelly's yelling, and I'm, and all of a sudden, we hear this.
Oh, look at the truck. Look at the truck.
Oh, yeah, he hit hard, didn't he?
Look at that, you
know. Oh, look at the mass. He's thick. He's bleeding a bit on his neck.
Oh, yeah. Like 24 inch ears, 25.
Whoa, 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 whoa. If I can make a living from walking in the woods, you can bet I'd be sitting pretty good, high on a hill, looking at a field downwind. If I can make a nickel off of turning in bass, never worry about the price of gas. I've been wheeling and dealing and sitting there reeling them in. Hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing, loving.
Chris, what do you got to say, bud?
I got something to say to those guys. Thank you very much. Absolutely. It seems like moments like this follow us.
Yeah.
They just do. We're in a lot of pictures like this.
Got a lot of people in mind.
I get a little farm pond buzz. Found a gravel went back in.
You see him up there like a German short hair, just freaking pinned on him.
He's never shot that bottle.
200.
I didn't even sight it in. I just fouled the barrel and put that bullet in it. The guy that sold me the bullet said they shoot good.
Well, I'm glad to hear you found the barrel.
Yeah.
You know, a good start.
Lucky about it. He told me that where the gun shoots at 200. He said he'd shoot it. tennis ball at 200 yards. Yeah, that's about it. I mean, that was the reality. I prepared ourselves. I knew the ballistics on it. I knew where the stick was. His body's in the middle. I didn't have to aim high. He didn't aim low. Had a hole about the size of a freaking watermelon. Drove that in. Yep, and he's right. Exactly. It's interesting. That sight. You know, it's a range. Deep sight. It's kind of cool. It's got a cross. But I wouldn't have been able to see it. And I got him that time. I made a tiny piece of fence fiber from a bow sight and hit it right in the middle of the dang thing.
So you're lucky to put that fiber off the side of the dang.
Once again, the luck follows me. It was great. It was a neat afternoon. It was a great day.
Yeah. September 12th,
2017. Yeah. I'll be down here.
Day. Yeah.
Saturday, Sunday, Monday.
You got a whole week's worth of playing now, bro.
Just about got him Saturday.
We're going to butcher him. Yeah, we did.
About got him this morning.
You know what's interesting is I shot that deer 75 yards from where Kelly and I were set up and watched him Thursday. And he raised this little flat right through here.
Heck, I'm sure that log me and you spooning under it was around here somewhere.
Just right over there. Just in the car garden.
Y'all closing. Thanks. It wasn't CQ plus KM, was it? Or anything weird like that, was it?
It was just two vessels. Guys, well, thanks very, very, very much. I'm speechless. I've been sitting by this deer for 2 hours. And I'm just speechless.
Well, the best part about this whole hunt today is we dropped you off at 8:45 this morning.
Yeah.
It's
3:45.
Yeah, it was 3:45 when you finally pulled the trigger.
I'm kind of short on distance.
7 hours.
I'm only 3.2 into the two rambles.
7 hours and almost two of them. I'll bet you were standing pointing right at him. Won't you come along with me? That's a lot of pressure.
I took enough deep breaths like me before you take a shot. I know you yeah, I was able to keep going. I don't know how many times I took a deep breath, let it half out, and it just didn't look right. Eventually, they had a storm come in, the wind switched a little bit, and he quit chewing his cud. Now and ever, so. It worked. It didn't go. You can see that stick in the tree. It's been like 40 yards down the mountain. He probably tumbled. Oh, yeah. He rolled the dang tree. It was quick and quick. Now we're gonna feast on him.
Back straps, baby.
Garlic, butter, onion, pretty much everything that's good. Yep. That's kind of our thing. Every time we whack one, we send to pull his back out and eat it.
I didn't even bring nothing to eat. I just been waiting for these.
No doubt. Sean's had 2 grape nuts and a mouthful of cottage cheese in 5 days. Probably weighs about 113 now. He
nice
won the
thing
contest.
About that is you don't even need to bring toilet paper, though.
You don't.
You should have seen him down in the truck. He lost his spoon, so he's just slurping the cottage cheese out of a jug.
Like a dog. I probably got it all over. I got a round white thing, you know.
I sat up there watching you guys. But you know what? Once I found the deer, I don't think I looked at you again.
No.
I didn't. I couldn't.
I told Kelly because I said, maybe the batteries are dead. Kelly's like, no, the batteries are fine. I said, if he couldn't get a hold of us, he'd be looking around. I said, I've never seen the hat brim move from that deer. It's pointing right at it. The gun's right at it. I'm like.
Was it about 2 hours or?
Hour and a half at least. I mean,
no, it was 2 hours.
Kelly and I got so sick and tired of sitting there. We had to take turns. I'd get out and walk around because my butt was so sore. And then Kelly'd watch him. Then I'd get back in. Kelly'd get out and walk around. It was like.
Freaking
it worked
legs.
Perfectly. Because without, I don't know if I could have kept. I probably wouldn't have seen you shoot him.
Uh-huh. Were you in the scope when I shot?
Yep.
He was in the scope when I shot, but you were watching?
I was watching, and I'm like, Kelly, he shot. No, I said, he's up. I'm like, oh, he shot. And I could see him pedal. Right, I'm like, he's dead. I'm like, he's going down, and then.
And then I stuck my eye to the scope. He was on the death run. I was just like, holy shit. And then he just rolled over backwards, and it was like, I went completely stupid, bailed out of the truck. I was hooting and hollering. And then it went freaking like, I was like on the tail end of my hooping and hollering. I could hear your ass over me. Seriously, I was like
a war cry.
Oh my God.
That may be as loud as I've ever yelled. I couldn't believe it. I mean, you try and imagine, and you put this picture together in your head of what could happen. And I'm thinking, honestly, with the storm and the swirling winds, he's just going to blow off of that bed, and I'm not going to take a running shot at him at that range, you know? But it didn't work that way. He moved over enough, and I could see that bright white face of his, that was my reference, and that dark body. And
boom.
Boom. There you go, boy. Squeeze that trigger and that thing goes where you send it.
Sean was down there telling me how he's like, that better be this deer's last nap.
I told him when it laid down, I said, that's his last nap.
Yeah, when he laid down,
kinda,
I'm like,
I was kind of half joking. I said, that's his last nap. I'm like, the next one's going to be a dirt nap.
Yeah,
it was.
That's what we were saying. We're like, star four just aligned. Let's just wait for the last one to hit it.
Kelly said, the four stars have aligned. We just need the fifth one and we'll be in good shape.
Well, I remember looking at my watch and it was like 2 o'clock, I think. It must have been two when I was looking at him. I know it was 2 o'clock and I'm like, buddy, I got 5 hours and I'm going to keep this thing pointed at you the whole freaking time. So we'll see who's got more patience.
You know what? You know what?
I was just glad you found him because in our sculpts, he was a pain in the ass to find.
Well, we had to go back down.
Yeah.
Couldn't see him. There.
Couldn't find him.
All I saw was from here out behind that log.
Good eye.
That's it.
When Kelly and I
were. Damn good.
But I didn't know he was there. I could have been picking my nose and eating a sandwich. Well, I guess I didn't have a sandwich or anything to drink. That's fine. But I could have just not been as careful moving, not had the gun pointed right on him, all those things. But there was no margin once his head came out because I'm right there.
The only real lucky thing, really, I think that was the make or break, Kel, with this whole deal. And we could have got lucky in another way. But realistically, what was lucky was when that 2-point hauled ass that way down the canyon until we couldn't even see him no more. And for whatever reason, this buck decided to come 50 yards this way.
He wanted back to his bedroom.
Well, we've seen him do it 3 times.
He wanted to go back to his bedroom, and you were just in it.
And that's one of the reasons I kind of just stayed there.
Yeah.
I'm like, we've seen him do it. He wants to get back over there.
Yep.
And let's just stay put.
He let all the other deer go, and he just stayed there. And that's when Kelly and I were kind of like, okay, the good news now is we're dealing with 2 eyes instead of 10.
Yeah.
You know.
You know what kills more of these things than anything? The living patience.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You know? Well, if you would have seen him.
If
and
I
then got anxious and shot, you know what I mean?
Yeah, could
most have. People shoot before they're ready, and you were smart enough to wait 2 hours to know. That, in my opinion, that's where people mess up. They take too quick a shot with the bow. They take it at 40 when he's coming.
Yeah.
Let him come to 15 or 10 or 20.
There's
or with a rifle, they see him at 400, let him come.
Yeah,
you know?
Get him close.
Or
we've
if
talked
he's running,
about that.
And he's running at 150, let him run to 300 and stop.
Yeah.
You just got to be patient. It'll kill him. Yep, you did it. Perfect.
Fun.
It's what dreams are made of, man.
Thanks again, brothers.
Well done.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Another hunt in the bag.
Biggest buck on the map.
Best part about this whole deal that I'm starting to like what's going on is we're not going the duration of the hunt.
Yeah.
We're getting in, getting shit done, getting out.
Yeah. Now we need to go home and help the boys get a bow buck.
Yeah,
or
we can do all those fun things.
Go home
hang
and eat
out.
Some of these.
Yeah.
Go what do you think your boys are going to say when they see this son of a bee?
Oh, they're going to go crazy. I'm so excited to tell them.
Tyson's going to crap.
You know, I'm excited to tell Jake. In April.
Yep.
I'm excited to tell all those guys.
And what's his name?
Dusty.
Dusty for, yep.
Yeah.
Corey for being out here.
Yep. Yeah, they're gonna be surprised. I'll bet you money they look up at this tangled jungle Rambo mess and they go,
You can walk through it. And trust me, we've been in we haven't been in every square inch. I'm not gonna say that, but we've been through miles of it and it's not freaking easy. You can see what we've got to get out and you can look at this.
Well, you remember what Dusty said yesterday morning. First thing he said is he's like, that stuff ain't as good as you think it is. That stuff's hard as hell to get through.
Yeah, and
sneaking
is
almost impossible.
You're just kind of hopping log to log. I guess you know what? Guy just about exercise, kind of got ready for this hunt. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to do it either.
No.
Yep. You wouldn't have made it up here the third or fourth time, you know?
I sat down here, and I sat down by him after I found him, and just thank God he gave me the body I got.
I knew
and
it.
Kept me healthy. And
I knew it. I knew when the first thing you got down here would be that you'd thank God, and I knew it.
I did. I just... Although... I question the vision in my right eye. I'm going to take that up with the eye doctor.
Don't take that one up with God.
Yeah. He did just fine.
Well, let's get him taken care of.
Should we take him apart, boys?
Yep.
Well, that's exciting.
It is exciting.
Beautiful.
It's,
Katie and the kids are going to,
gonna
be pretty
that.
Excited for you.
This is what we've been planning since Jake was nice enough to slip me that voucher. And this was our intentions.
Yep.
I said we're going to kill 170 plus or we're not going to kill, and that was it. I'm happy not killing. We did everything we said we're going to do. It's been a blast.
Yep. Perfect.
Thanks, fellas.
Yep.
Appreciate it.
Good job, buddy.
Thanks.